Welcome to the great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go. The path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And our topic today is change your life. Many people talk about repentance, but to repent your sin alone is not enough. What follows true repentance is a change in your life. All the sins that you have repented of, you will not do again. You bury your past completely, and then you clean up all your environment, and you start a new life in Christ Jesus. And to start a new life means to change your life. Do not do the sins from before again. Pray against the evil forces. Rebuke the evil forces. Pray that the Holy Spirit and that Jesus, our Lord and Savior, will help you on that new path. A path that is clear of sin. Of course, we cannot be 100% clear of sin because we are born into a sinful nature. But we can give up the sins that we repented for. If you use alcohol, give it up. If you smoke, give it up. If you do immorality, give it up. And there are many of the sins that can be given up. And by giving up the sins, you change your life. And you start a new and righteous life onto the new path. And if you then choose the path to Mount Zion and become a follower of Jesus Christ completely, then you are now walking on that narrow path that will lead to salvation and to eternal life. So repentance alone is not enough. You also have to change your life. It's like, if I put it drastically, it's like shooting yourself in your head and burying yourself very deep. This is your past is gone and now you start a new life. Your mind will start a new life without sins, without this bad behavior that you had before. You died for Christ and then you start a new life. It is your burial and your birthday at the same time. How wonderful is this if you get the chance to start a new life? Without sin, without the interference of the devil and his evil forces. Now you are truly set free. You are set free from that nature. You are set free from the influences of the prince of the air. And you can now concentrate fully on your walk with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So change your life. Do not repent alone. Repent of all your sins and then chase the sins out of your life. Bury them as deep as you can. Change your life to become a better person. Change your life to show forth the love of the Father to your neighborhood. Change your life to come together in love, unity and support. Change your life to share your resources and support one another. The time of troubles are at hand. The sealed tribulation is right now at our doorstep. And in this tribulation, we must come together. And by coming together in assemblies of love and righteousness, we will serve our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and his Father, Lord Jehovah. We serve him because we love him above all else. And we love our neighbor as ourselves. On these two commandments are hanging all the law and all the prophets. That's what our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ said. So show forth your love and your unity in Christ as brothers and sisters and as followers of the path, as Rosarians with triple grace, as daily sacrifices, who will go out and support the needy, the nameless and faceless, every day, but not to make a public show like others do. No, do it in secret. When you go out every day to help people, let your left hand not know what your right hand is doing. Do it in humility, in private. Do not call the newspaper or the TV stations to film you when you do something good. Do it in private. Do it as a humble servant of the Lord. And do not make any of the things that are given from the Holy Spirit and that are given free to us. Do not make any of these items an idol. Do not make baptism, speaking in tongues, or any of these free gifts from the Holy Spirit, do not make them an idol. Many people do that. They say, without you are water baptized, and without speaking in tongues, you cannot be saved. That is making them an idol. And it's not true. So please stay humble. Humble yourself in front of the Lord. But still, come together in love, unity, and support. And the people will recognize you. You do not have to shout in the streets, and you do not have to shout from the rooftop. The people will recognize you because you will have a change in your life and a change of heart. And people will say, this person before was very hot-tempered. What happened to him? Now he is so friendly and so gentle. That is because you have not only repented of your sins, of hot temper, but you have chased it away and you have changed your life. And people will recognize you for that. They will not recognize for you that you are shouting in the street, that you try to convert people who do not want to be converted. People should be guided by the Holy Spirit to your ministry, and you should not go forth and shout in the streets. Jesus was not going into the streets and shouting. He always tried to avoid the crowds. And he always told the people that he has healed, do not tell anybody. Because it was not from him, it was through the heavenly gifts and through the Holy Spirit that he healed the people. So you have to understand, if you can bring people on the righteous path and to righteousness, then it is through the Father in heaven, through Jesus Christ and through the Holy Spirit, and not because of your own effort. If you say it's because you are better than the others, then you elevate yourself, and then you are not humble anymore. So change your life completely, stay always humble, and become a true servant of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you that you have listened to this topic, and I hope I will see you again tomorrow. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.